Dustin Lynch here with the Arkansas CW, still at the Bentonville Film Festival, where I am here with the director of the movie Painted Woman. Why don't you introduce yourself, sir?
Hey, I'm James Cotten, Fort Smith guy. So
hey.
this is like homecoming for me. I'm having a good time getting to bring a movie back here.
Yeah. It really is cool because I'm asking all these LA people, what do you think of Arkansas? And they're like, oh, it's beautiful, it's green. And you're like, right,
it's home. Time slows down. My accent comes back.
Right. You know? It's very. you've had a pretty cool career, and like I can understand getting out of Fort Smith into filmmaking is not an easy task.
Right.
And you managed to do that.
Yeah, dude. I got lucky. I was when I started off, I got lucky because I was Tuskegee Airmen was a movie HBO did with Lawrence Fishburne and Malcolm Jamal Warner and Cuba Gooding Jr.
Right.
And they were shooting in Fort Smith and Muskogee.
Yeah.
And I was a news guy, and I went to do a story on the audition process.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't let me tape somebody else auditioning, but they let me tape myself auditioning.
Okay.
So I end up auditioning for the movie,
sure.
And I got a part.
That is so cool.
So that's kind of, and like I worked on the movie for like 30 days.
Right.
I totally tripped into the movie industry, and I was like, dude, wait, this is what I like. This
Only
is what I want to do, right?
Yeah.
Then it's been a trail after that.
That's pretty awesome. Let's shoot on your movie a little bit. Like, what the big topic for it is right now is how cool it is to have a male woman lead in a Western.
Yeah.
Now, why don't you tell me a little bit how you feel about it?
I mean, well, look, when we started, this is a lot of Arkansas filmmakers, right? Like the producers are Arkansas filmmakers. It's based on, inspired by and a book of a author that lives here in Fayetteville. And the idea was to take that kind of Western novel, that thing, and then flip it on its head and tell the female's perspective, in the story. And, through the process, like what I found was like finding, something where it had meaning, that you could tell the story of people that are abused and how they become abused.
Sure.
That it's not just, happenstance. It's
right.
Like, people drive them into that life, and then it's how we come out.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's the people that are good in our lives that can be the support structure for somebody, in our case, the character Julie Richards.
Sure.
That is the only way that abused people can find their way out of it.
Yeah.
So I think it's a universal story. I think, if you like Westerns, you're going to, be into it because it's just a time period thing.
Right.
But if we can say something that means something inside of that, that's where, movies transcend, right?
Those are my favorite type of movies, where you're entertained and then you actually learn something. And if you can take away anything from a movie, then the film, you've done your job.
That's the job, man. If there's like different things, if you want to like be pure entertainment, you can sure you can do that. We're talking about my first film, my biggest film was La Línea.
Right.
And that's a drug cartel story, and there's some, there's some underlying themes inside of that, but they're a little more hidden.
Sure, yeah.
It's still just like, you put a gun in Ray Liotta's hand and watch the magic happen.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, exactly.
But with a film like this, we really searched for you've never seen anything like this.
Right.
I'm telling you, I broke the story into it's right in half. And there's a front story and a back story. Each have three acts.
Yeah.
And then the overall movie has three acts.
Right.
So, if you're a filmmaker and a geek and you geek out on story, there's like something for you in there. If you just like a Western story, there's something for you. If you like Steph Dawson, there's something for you.